Teresa, so you're the queen of emotional intelligence, if I may say, and you have the expertise. So can you share us more about that, and how can job seekers benefit from EQ? And is it different during crisis mode and during normal parts, normal days?
Yeah.
Is it different or is it the same?
So here's the thing, you know, emotional intelligence skills are really valuable when we're emotional. I mean, if we're not emotional, if we're not charged up, those we don't need those skills because we're not emotional about it. Our emotional information is sort of neutral. It's not driving the bus.
Yes.
But when our emotions get in the driver's seat, and this could even be if I'm ecstatic before I have to step on stage to speak to a group of people, I get really excited.
Yes.
And that energy causes me to speak so fast. So if I don't harness that excited energy and bring that emotional state down to joyful, then the audience experiences a rapid pace that is very difficult to listen to. And so that emotional state derails me from being successful. Oftentimes people will just think about it in the negatively labeled emotions, like angry, frustrated, irritated, agitated, offended. You have to remember emotional intelligence is all emotions, no labels. This is information we need to know how to use. And it's been around for a really long time. It just seems like it's more important now. So if we think about how long it's been around, when any of us has been asked to describe our favorite teacher, our most influential coach, our best friend, we've provided answers that are all related to EQ skills. They listen to me. They care about me. They share their thoughts in a respectful way, even when we disagree. They make me feel important. They help me solve problems. We work really well together. They're really positive. They're a great cheerleader for my talents. Like, we know what EQ skills are almost intuitively. And we know when people have them, and we definitely know when people don't. So job seekers, I believe, need to be ready to talk about their EQ skills. It's how they are over what they can do. So education and experience are valuable. Absolutely. And we put these generally at the top of our resume. Yes. And we highlight them in our cover letter, right? With EQ and emotional intelligence floating to the top of what job seekers are looking for, or sorry, what employers are looking for, job seekers need to float these things to the top of their resume. So it's time to focus on their why and their how. Simon Sinek is the guru of why, right? So he actually provides, even on his website, excellent exercises for finding your why and being able to articulate your why. It's a necessary piece, I think, for job seekers, for anyone on the planet, really, to know what is your why. Because then you're connected to your purpose. Now, your how is, it's your value system. How do you go about living your why? It's through these things that people see it demonstrated. And the what are all of the hats. I'm a mom. I'm a sister. I'm a wife. I'm an EQ coach. I'm a whatever. You put the hat on. Those are the whats. So I do believe that spending that time to really get to know yourself so you can humbly speak about yourself in the interview process is probably a really critical piece for job seekers now to include in their preparation for.
I agree with you. And especially nowadays, having a value alignment with your personal value and the company is also important. That also shows your cultural fit, or you have, you're breeding the same values. That's also important because you need to know your who you are and what you can offer before going to any job interview.
Yeah, I agree. And I kind of disagree with that because, you know, a company will put their values on the wall and sometimes they have 2, 3, 5, 10 who knows how many they may have. And you may have figured out like your top 10 and you have some that sort of loop over, which is great. So you have some alignment. Do I need to have my top five are the same as your top? No, I don't. I need to know what that looks like. And I need to be able to speak to how I can demonstrate that. And knowing my EQ means I can start to talk about it in times of crisis, of stress, when the stakes are high, when the chips are down, I use these core values of mine to demonstrate that core value of yours. Wow.
That's an aha moment. I believe, I hope the job seekers can take that into account when going for their next interview, especially now with the crisis happening. Again, thank you, Teresa, for those great telling people how they can use their EQ during interviews. And again, for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips, please leave it in the comment section. Like and share the video, subscribe to the channel, and tune in next time for another great question with Teresa.